Hi guys, how are you doing? I hope you're good. You're highly welcome back to our channel. Yes guys, do you know that even when they've condemned you, that mercy say no? Do you know that mercy can undo everything that was done, holding you down in captive, delaying you in marital settlement, delaying you not to have child? Okay, a lot of sacrifice that was done that you are not aware of. Do you know that mercy can say no and redeem you? If you have not watched this video, please sit down to listen to this video, because it's going to mean a lot to you. Yes, to my return subscribers, thank you for always being there, coming back to watch my videos, for your comments, for your support, for your prayers. I want to say thank you. Honestly, you people are really bringing out the hidden part of me. Yes, your questions will push me to go further, you know. And if you're just seeing my face for this first time, my name is Mercy, and it's all about simple solutions to the challenges of life. Please consider to subscribe at the end of this video. If you like this video, you find it interesting, charming, give me a like, okay? Put your comments at the comment section, and I will answer you when I'm less busy. Yes, guys, I want you to know that mercy cancel judgments. Mercy say no, you will not be condemned. Mercy redeems you. Mercy is the bedrock of the life that you are living. I remember a man's story. I listened to his testimony. He was an armed robber. Yes, he was condemned to die by, not by hanging. So they asked him to say their last prayer. And he just said, "Have mercy on me. Save me, I will serve you." And before they would have carried the execution, there was a call. There was an instruction, because mercy intervened. Mercy stepped in at that moment, and he was saved. That was how he became a child of God, born again. He said he cried to unknown God, but mercy intervened. A lot of us are suffering from a crime we never committed. Some of you, you are aware, they've told you that your father sacrificed your life, sacrificed your wealth for his own. So you are to be poor, he will be rich. They've told you that your grandfather has killed a lot of people, committed a lot of atrocity before he died. They told you your grandmother did this and that. You know that from the foundation of the beginning, there has been an error. What did you do? How do you liberate yourself? How do you cancel that judgment? The only thing that can liberate you, cancel that judgment, is the mercy of God. Is the mercy of God. This mercy, I'm going to show you how to channel yourself to God. It's not just this one you wake up and say, "Mercy, mercy, mercy, mercy." No, there is more to it. For example, you are a woman. You have committed a lot of abortion. And as a result of those abortion and those lives that you live, you cannot conceive again. You need to ask for mercy in this way. For mercy will replace, will repair your womb that has been damaged. You know, you did one thing. This one is almost common in the life of some women. You are married. You are in your husband's house. Mistakenly, you slept with another man, and it results to pregnancy. You gave back to that child. Every day you wake up, you look at that child. You look at the man. You know very well that you are not the father of this child. You know you are living with that guilt. You are living with that burden, that pain in you, because it's an everlasting pain. You are dead. The thing is eating you up. You wish to confess. You wish to restitute, but the boldness is not there. The fear of losing your husband, losing your home is there. Because of that, you are dying in silence. You are there. Let me tell you, if you like speak in tongues, if you like be a prayer warrior, be a prophet, be a prophetess, if you die in that guilty, you are going to hell. All right. You're going to channel your prayer like this. Ask God for mercy so that he will clear you up. Once he clears you up, the boldness will come. The channel for you to restitute, confess your sin and restitute, the door will be open that time. Okay. Now, I want you to know that mercy of God can undo everything that was done delaying you not to prosper. The mercy of God can undo that. Okay, you find out you have been praying, you have been looking for solution. Anywhere you go to find solution, the spirit will go there to say, no, he's my captive, he must not be free. Anywhere you go to find solution, those that want to give you solution, we have problem. I remember one day I was living somewhere, and I told one guy, Anna, I'm going to help you with this. On my way going, there was an Okada accident. If not that I was vigilant enough, I would have sustained a very strong injury. That is the forces following that guy that does not want any helper to come. Sometimes when that man wants to help you, that is when they will take your face to go and torment the man in the dream. They will carry cutlass and be chasing the man up and down. Okay. You know you have fasted, you have prayed, you have sown seed, you have given thanks, you have given to the poor, to the widow, you have cast, you have burned, you have done vigils, you have done praise nights, you have paid your tithes or whatever you have done, and everything you are doing, it looks as if the door is still closed. Mercy is going to unlock that door. Mercy is going to break that chain and set you free. Okay. Now, how do you do this prayer of mercy? Channeling your mercy to your prayer of mercy to God. You have a court case. You know that when they judge you, they may plead, they may condemn you that you are guilty. It due to some things. It may not really an improper case or you kill anybody, but they may send you to a jail for some reason. Maybe they use your name to commit fraud. You're going to be doing this prayer of mercy. Now, in doing this prayer of mercy, it depends on your own case. Like I said, if your case is really tough, you know you will go higher. If your own is mild, you know where you will stop. You'll be needing a white candle. This white candle, you can cut it into half. Okay? Maybe your candle is very long. You can cut it into half. You'll be using half so that it can burn down easily. All right. Now, this prayer of mercy, it does not really have a specific time. You can do it at any time. You can do it at any time that is convenient for you, in the evening or in the afternoon. All right. But even if you are doing that candlelight in the evening, you're going to carry out a fast. You're going to carry out a fast. Your fasting can be in these two forms. One, it can be the forms that you will fast. Your food is only fruit and water. Fruit and water. You must not eat anything that has oil or anything cooked on the fire. That is one. In those days, you want to carry out this prayer of mercy. They call it like white fasting. Okay, you must not eat anything that has oil or anything cooking on the fire. So you can go on with fruits and water. That is it. Two, you can decide to fast 6 to 12, 6 to 3, or 6 to 6. When you know that your case is tough, too much, you go for 6 to 6. Now you're going to start your prayer 6 a.m. in the morning. You will pray, asking God for mercy. I will show you the scriptures you'll be using. Afternoon, you ask God for, 6 in the morning, ask for mercy. 9 in the morning, you're going to be asking God for mercy. Even if you are at work, you are carrying that fasting. You can, with your heart, you are meditating Once it's that time, you are meditating, asking God for mercy. You can go to restroom to make the prayer. Just 5 minutes, asking God for mercy. 12, afternoon, you're going to ask God for mercy. You're going to ask Him for mercy. Father, mercy, I call for mercy. Let the door of mercy open. Overshadow me with your mercy. Based on this case, I need to be free. I need you to solve this problem. 3 o'clock is very important. 3 o'clock and 12 o'clock. Now let me tell you, there's an angel that moved by 6. There's an angel that moved around by 9 to collect another prayer request. There's an angel that moved around by 12. Okay, and 3 is the hour of mercy. Yes, 3 is the hour of mercy. So when the angel is moving around by 3, you already connecting by praying. Then 6 in the evening, you'll be breaking your prayer. After you have done praying, by 6 you're still going to pray. If you are doing 6 to 6, by 6 you will break your fasting. You will eat your food. Or anytime you will break your fasting, you eat your food. But by 6 you're going to be praying. When you are done with what you are doing in the evening, when you are about to, before you go to bed, you're going to be lighting your candle and asking for mercy. You must not wear black when you pray during this prayer of mercy. Whether going to work, going to shopping mall, going to market, you must wear a bright color. Okay. During the time you are lighting your candle, you must wear something bright, preferably white. White pajamas or whatever, white or any bright color, but you must not wear black. Yes, you must not wear black on this, so that your prayer will go straight. Okay, now you're going to be using Psalm 25, Psalm 51, Psalm 61, 65, and Psalm 102 verse 13. You're going to be using all these psalms to pray and asking God for mercy. You can write your prayer point. For example, there's a particular thing you desire so much. You want the mercy of God to intervene, to come into that issue. You want the mercy of God to solve that problem now. You want the mercy of God to unlock that door that have been locked. You want the mercy of God to overshadow you for this particular journey you want to embark on. You want the mercy of God to cancel your name in the book of death and write your name in the book of life. You want the mercy of God to cancel joblessness and give you job. You want the mercy of God to set you maritally. You want the mercy of God to give you a children. You want the mercy of God to intervene in that case. You'll be carrying out this your prayer like this. And this prayer goes to 4 days, 7 days. 4 days, 7 days. You'll be doing this prayer, okay? 4 days is like 4 count, 9 points. 7 days is perfection. You can also write your prayer point when you're praying for the mercy. As you light your candle, you'll be praying, you hold your prayer point, leading that the mercy of God solve this problem, the mercy of God intervene in your case. Brethren, if you cry for mercy, maybe your son, your husband, your daughter, somebody is ill, all the medication is not working, you can embark, enter the prayer of mercy in agreement with the Lord. Okay, he said his mercies endure forevermore. Psalm 136, oh, give thanks, for the Lord is good, and his mercies endure forevermore. Because the mercy of God never ceases. But it depends how you channel it. If you channel your prayer like this, I can assure you that the doors that will open, it will surprise you. This is how you'll be doing this prayer of mercy, in order to attract the presence of God to solve your problem and cancel every judgment. You'll be discharged and appointed. All right, this is what I want to share with you.